At the heart of Hive are two master and two sub oscillators, paired up on the left and right hand sides of the interface. Both master-sub pairs are identical in terms of control, with the mix balance between them established using their four volume knobs. Each of the four oscillators can output one of nine analog-style waveforms selected in the wave menu. The two main oscillators also include a wavetable option, and selecting Like Osc for either sub-oscillator sets it to the same shape as its associated master oscillator. The sine, saw, triangle and square options will be familiar to anyone who's ever used an analog synth before, while pulse, half and narrow are pulse waves of three widths. Although it doesn't have its own dedicated controls in the oscillator panels, pulse width modulation is available by assigning constant, or any other source, to the hidden pulse width target in the modulation matrix. The remaining two analog waveforms, white and pink, are noise generators. Selecting the wavetable option for an oscillator pulls up a second menu below, giving access to Hive's extensive library of factory wavetables, arranged in descriptively named categories. Complex, harmonic, formants, etc. You can add your own WAV and UHM files to the list too. See the included documentation for details. Each wavetable consists of up to 256 single-cycle waves, called frames, which can be scanned through manually or via modulation to make interesting evolving sounds. Loading a wavetable puts its waveform in the graphical oscillator display and brings its controls up in the wavetable 1 or 2 tab of the central hexagon, along with a brief description and the number of frames it contains. To scan through the wavetable, either drag vertically on its waveform in the oscillator display or manipulate the top row position knob in the wavetable section. To the right of that, the one-shot and loop modes automatically modulate the wavetable position for the duration of the triggering note at a speed set by the tempo control. One-shot scans through the wavetable once, starting at its currently set position, while the two loop modes scan through it repeatedly from left to right or bouncing continuously between left and right. Activating cyclic mode smooths the jump transition from the last frame to the first and enables looped playback to cycle through the end of the wavetable back to the start. Switching to reverse mode reverses the wavetable itself, not the direction of playback through it. The table's parameter divides the wavetable into up to 16 layers, enabling two dimensions of position scanning. The frames within the wavetable are automatically split across the layers, so if you set a 32-frame wavetable to two tables, table 1 contains frames 1 to 16, while table 2 consists of frames 17 to 32. With four tables, the split becomes frames 1 to 8, 9 to 16, 17 to 24, and 25 to 32. Sweeping the lower position knob manually or via modulation, crossfades up and down through the layers, and by combining that with modulation of the horizontal position, all sorts of spectacular waveform animations can be created. The Interpolator menu provides four styles of interpolation, governing the smoothness and character of transition through the wavetable frames. Switch deactivates interpolation for discrete stepping between frames, while crossfade interpolates the amplitude of all harmonics between adjacent frames. With its minimal CPU hit, this is usually the one to go for. The spectral and zero phase algorithms expand on crossfade by interpolating the phase of the harmonics in each frame as well as their amplitude, and locking the phase of every harmonic to zero, thereby eliminating phase cancellation, respectively. Back in the main oscillator section, the unison menu lets you stack up to 16 unison voices for a bigger, thicker sound. Unison only works on the sub-oscillator when its wave is set to like osc. Detuning the voices in the unison stack is done with the detune knob, which spreads them increasingly further apart around the central pitch. Hold the shift key for finer resolution. The sound of the unison engine is strongly affected by the active synth engine, as switched using the three buttons below the data display. Tuning of the master oscillators is handled by their octave and semitone controls, offering transposition up to three octaves in either direction, and each sub-oscillator's pitch is offset from its master oscillator by its tune knob, which defaults to an octave below at minus 12. When unison is set to 1, i.e. off, the detune knob is used for fine-tuning of both master and sub-oscillators. Even with unison at 2 or more though, you can still fine-tune the oscillators by assigning the constant modulation source to the tune target and adjusting the modulation depth. Pan and width knobs control the stereo imaging of each oscillator pair. Pan moves the main mono output left and right, while width spaces any unison voices out around it. Three oscillator phase modes are accessible from the phase menu. Reset has the wave re-triggering at 0 degrees for consistent attacks. Random starts the wave at a random point with every new note. And Flow sees the phase of each note continuing seamlessly into the next. Phase is also a modulation target. Hive boasts a dedicated vibrato LFO for wobbling the pitch of held notes, the parameters of which are housed in the keys panel. The depth with which this is applied to each oscillator is dialed in with the vibrato knobs. Finally, the four S buttons solo their respective oscillators, and complete oscillator setups can be saved, recalled, and copied between the two via the menus at the top of each oscillator.